Welcome, everybody. You are now watching OGTV. Yeah.
I think a lot of people are starting to understand that when they meet the new me, I give off this mentality that, like, I really don't care about what people say. I don't care about how they feel about me because they have no reason to feel any different than the energy that I put off to them. Positive, respectful, I'm chill. There's no reason to hate on me. Certain things don't add up sometimes, but I really don't let it faze me. And I don't let shit faze me. That's what it's really about. Not letting shit faze you, for real.
Honestly, I don't be feeling better from beefing or having a problem, holding on to that hostile energy. I don't feel better from that. I honestly feel better from letting go of that energy, thinking about positive things, and just breathing, being happy, living, enjoying my life. Like, this is what life is about. Enjoying your life, taking the time to make the right decisions, because you only live one life and you shouldn't be wasting your life getting mad about some dumb shit. Does that make sense? Because, I mean, anybody that knows me, whether we went through some shit in the past or now, let that shit go. Like, it's not that deep. Life is too short. How many friends have you lost? How many family members have you lost this year for you to realize that life is way too short to be thinking about all that negative shit? I realized after going through so much with so many people that I love and that I thought I love, just how to put all of that emotion and affection and all of that energy into something positive. Because when you notice you go back and forth and you complain about how your day's going, or you focus on the negative, it's like feeding into your brain. Sometimes it makes you feel like your life is shitty or you're failing all the time. I can't even buck. I can't even lie. I've been living a lot of my life feeling like I'm a failure or feeling like I'm a mess up, I'm a screw up, just because, you know, also I've heard words put into my mouth. I've been bullied for quite some time. And, you know, I really don't feel like I would be who I am if I didn't go through that. Because now, to this very moment, to this very day, I'm a very good friend to people. I'm just a very good friend. I listen to people's problems. I give them open and honest answers, whether they like it or not. I try to have the best interest at their heart. You know what I'm saying? I really try to just pray for people. That's really important for me, to just continue to pray for people every day, no matter if I know them or not. Pray for your family, your loved ones, your mother, your father, homeless people, people in different countries. We might have a good, we might have a bad day, but you gotta understand that there's other people out there that have it way worse. And it just humbles me down for a second, because there are people out there that really have it way worse. I have both of my parents, and I'm so blessed for them. I have siblings, and I'm blessed for my siblings. I had two dogs. Unfortunately, they both passed away, but I was so blessed that God, you know, decided to bless me with two dogs. You know what I'm saying? Like, I try not to let these things get to me. I really try not to, because that's letting the devil win, for real, for real. And I'm just completely tired of seeing my society let the devil get to them, because that's what it really is. The devil. The devil. If there is one thing I had to tell somebody that asked me for advice when it came to deciding what you want to do, always stick with what your heart tells you. Never settle for anything less. I'm not the type to settle. I've been in that situation where
my parents want me to do one thing and I want to do another. But as long as you're happy, that's the only thing that matters. Always do what your heart tells you to do. And another thing would be, never let anybody stop you. Never let anybody tell you you can't do what you want to do. Because the day that you let somebody tell you something and you go with that, you will never be successful. And that's just my perception. I've honestly met people that would say the same exact thing, because when you think about it, nobody's living your life for you. You're the only person living your life. And it's really important that you stick to your gut feeling, stick to your heart and your soul, and always, 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 and I mean always, always, stay true to yourself. Never change for anybody. Never try to fit in. Be the in crowd. People love me. People like me for who I am. People love what I wear. People love my personality. And that's because I am one in a million. There's not another me. There will never be another me. There's nobody that can dress like me. And that's one thing that I would tell everybody if I could. Just always stick to yourself. You are original. Originally you. And there's nobody else that can fit that job but you. So it's like...
Sometimes I think pain is just a lack of understanding. If we could only understand it all, would we feel no pain?
Would we feel no pain?
Would we feel no pain?
God must feel no pain.
Something's gotta hold on me.
Only joy.